Welcome to Corey's Conscious Living. Hello, my friends. Do you love Heidi, Cherry, and Vaya? And you would love if you got exclusive stories that weren't available anywhere else. If you join my Patreon Cat Club, you will get 3 stories every month for $7 on the 7th of every month. If you want to join the club and it's okay with your guardians or your parents, then follow the link below and become a patron and join the Cat Club. Namaste, my little friends. Are you ready to meditate with Corey? Are you ready to be super quiet so you can relax in your bed and let go of your busy day? Hopefully you brushed your teeth. You're in your comfortable pajamas and all is well in the world. Heidi, Cherry, and Vaya were cooking together in the kitchen. Cherry was chopping up the onions. They were making spaghetti bolognese. I really like spaghetti bolognese, said Heidi. I think it's one of my favorites. Vaya said, sometimes it's a bit messy, but I do enjoy it. Cherry said, You're right. Spaghetti bolognese is like one of the messiest meals ever. Especially when you slurp your spaghetti and then the tomato sauce splashes all over your face. It's so much fun, but it's so messy. As Cherry was talking, the onions started to work their magic. And Cherry's eyes started to run as if she was crying. OMG! OMG! Look at me eyes! Me eyes are running! Heidi said, that's what happens when you have onions, you know, when you cut them up and chop them up for things. I didn't know that, said Cherry. This has never happened to me before. I swear I've chopped an onion before. This is not my first rodeo when it comes to chopping onions. And I don't think I've ever had runny eyes like this. Makes me feel like I'm literally crying. And then Cherry started to make noises as if she was crying, like whimpering noises. Heidi said, are you okay, Cherry? Cherry said, not really, no. Now that I've started crying, even though I wasn't sad or anything, I just want to have a good cry. Cherry was bawling as she was cutting the onions. Vaya put down the tomatoes that she was chopping and walked over to where Cherry was to give her a big hug. So did Heidi. Both of her sisters were hugging on Cherry, trying to make her feel better. She said, I don't know why I'm crying. You know, sometimes though, you know, like you've had a busy day or somebody says something or like, you know, you just feel emotional and you're like, I don't know what's wrong with me right now and all inside feels all churny and funny and like you seem so sensitive and you're like, I think I just need to cry. And then when you have a cry, sometimes you get a little bit embarrassed about crying, don't you? I feel a little bit embarrassed about crying, especially over onions. Heidi said, don't worry. You must have felt like you needed to cry. It's okay to cry sometimes, you know, just for no reason. Did you know that when you cry, it's a way that your body releases energy, like trapped energy from the day? So if something's happened and at one moment, maybe you were in school and you got a little bit upset or you got a little bit stressed, then in that moment, nothing happened and you seemed to be okay. But then that energy of being stressed or upset gets trapped in your body. In your energy, in your body. And then, when you cry, that energy is released. That's why babies cry. Babies cry because they're talking to us. They're telling us they're hungry, or they're cold, or they're tired, or they need something. But they also cry to release their energy.
Oh, that makes so much sense, said Cherry. I remember when I was smaller, you know. Oh, this is bringing a lot back.
I remember, right, when I was smaller, that I was like a toddler, like a kitten. You know, like a kid would be a toddler. I was like the equivalent. I was like a kid. Well, no, a kitten. And I was like playing with all these other kittens. And I remember that I was playing with this like fluffy mouse thing. And all these other kittens that I were playing with took this fluffy mouse thing. And I didn't know how to say, hey, that's my mouse. Because I distinctly remember thinking, that's my mouse, and now they've got my mouse. And I couldn't understand why they got my mouse when it was my mouse. And I didn't know what to say, and I didn't know what to do, and I didn't know how to go over and say, can you please give me my mouse? Because I don't think I was mature enough, because I was just a kitten. And all I could see was that was my mouse. And I was so upset, and I was crying and crying and crying. And after I cried, I felt so much better.
Heidi said, that's exactly what I'm talking about. It's just releasing built-up stress or emotions or energy that's in your body. Crying is like releasing toxins. Think of it like going to the toilet. It's exactly the same, Freya said.
Do you mean that when you go pee, it's the same as crying?
Heidi said, kind of, yeah. It's, if you think about it. I mean, crying should just be as normal as peeing. We have to pee, don't we? We have to release the toxins. We have to poop. We have to release the waste out of our body. So why get so upset about trying not to cry?
It's the same thing. It's just peeing from your eyes.
Cherry started laughing. And then she started crying again.
That's funny, but it's not.
Now I really want to cry.
There was this one time, right, that this bird flew by and I was like, oh, that's such a pretty bird. I don't know why that made me cry, but it did, because it was so pretty and it was so beautiful, and I was like, wow, that's so nice. I feel so emotional.
Do you know, Heidi, do you know sometimes, do you like want to cry when you're happy? Because I think that's really bizarre, don't you think? Because most people think that you just cry when you're sad, right? It's like you're angry. You punch things. No, you don't. No, you don't. You don't do that. You just maybe scream a little bit or stomp out your feelings, as Corey would say. We definitely don't punch people or other animals or anything like that, because that's very destructive and it's not healthy. But it's healthy, you know, if you punch a pillow when you're angry. You know, if you were in your bedroom and you got really angry and you just punched the pillow, you're releasing the energy, aren't you, Heidi?
Heidi said, kind of, yeah, exactly. You're like, you have all this energy that's bubbling inside of you, and then when you punch, you release. That's why it's sometimes really good to go for a run or exercise when you've got anger inside of your body, because that helps to just walk it out or run it out or do like kickboxing or taekwondo or something physical so that your body can release the energy. It's the same thing, Cherry, you're right.
I know I'm right. I knew that, like, when you have anger in your body and you can feel it, it's really good to just like pow and like release it. Well, you know what? But what I don't get is, when you're happy, right, when you're happy, you would think you'd just like laugh a lot, wouldn't you? You wouldn't think you'd cry. Sometimes it's like really weird. Like I said, I saw that bird and I was like, all my throat went tight and my heart got like all pumpy fasty and like swelled up a little bit, like, oh, like, you know, when you go like, oh, that's so nice. It was that nice, that bird.
that it made me, like, get all emotional and verklempt. And then all my throat went tight and I thought, I'm going to cry. I'm going to cry over a pretty bird. That's absolutely redonkulous.
Heidi said, not really, because the emotion of being so happy, just for no reason, like just so happy that you cry, is actually quite normal.
OMG, this world is so bizarre. And why is it then, Heidi, that some people get really embarrassed about crying? Because, you know...
Cherry was talking and she got like loads and loads and loads of snot coming out of her nose because she was crying so much. She wiped her nose and then carried on talking.
You know, I think that, you know, we shouldn't be embarrassed. I felt a little bit embarrassed there that the onions had, like, started something off inside of me. And then just that starting something off inside of me made me think about all these other things that were inside of my energy field. They were in my body. And I wasn't even thinking about them. And then when I started crying, I was like, oh, my God, it's so sad.
And then... Cherry started crying again. She had a cry for a few seconds and then she stopped and composed herself a little bit and then carried on talking.
And then I was like, I'm a bit embarrassed. I feel a bit uncomfortable.
Heidi said, that's because some people, and it's okay that they feel like this, but it's maybe probably a little bit healthier if they let themselves cry. But some people don't think it's a good thing to cry. Some people think that it's a sign of weakness if you cry. In our society, we're girls, but boys, sometimes they are brought up to think that they're not allowed to cry, that like it's a weakness if they cry, or they're being a sissy if they cry. Cherry said,
doesn't seem so fair, does it? You know, boys are human too. They're just like us girls. And I mean, yeah, they're different and everything, because some boys like some things and girls like some things, but some boys like some things that girls like and some things that girls like some things that boys like. And we get so complicated about what should just be boys and what should just be girls. It's a little bit of a shame, because I know, I listened to one of Corey's meditations, right? And she was talking about Fin and Fang.
Heidi said, do you mean Yin and Yang?
Yeah! Not Fin and Fang. Yin and Yang! Yeah, that's that like male and female energy, right? Yin is male. No, Yin is Yang energy, right? And Yang, no. Yin is girls and Yang is boys.
Heidi said, yeah, that's correct.
Cherry said, I know, because I'm so smart. So yeah, Yin and Yang energy, right? You know what though? When I was listening to Corey, she said that both males and females, boys and girls, have both of those energies inside them. They're not supposed to be like 50-50 or anything, but they have both in them. So me being a girl, I have a lot of yin, but I also have yang in me. And then like Tucker, for example, our friend Tucker, he's like yang, so he has lots of boy in him, but he also has yin in him because he also has some girl in him. So we have like both male and female energies inside of us, don't we? And if that's the case, then why aren't boys allowed to cry? Or if that's the case, why is crying just a girl thing? Why is crying a girl thing instead of a boy thing? Why is yang energy not crying and yin energy is like stifling in it and just being so strong and brave? Why? Who decided which energy was what, right? It just complicates things and it makes it so difficult. Why can't we just say, look, if you need to cry, you need to cry because you need to release something, like peeing. Crying is like peeing from your eyes, as you said, Heidi. And I think that's such a good thing to say. I think we should just make that a thing. I think I should have that on a t-shirt. Instead of OMG, I'm going to put, crying is peeing from your eyes. And it's very natural. I'd have to wear a big t-shirt. But I could just put, crying is like peeing from your eyes. And people would get what I mean, I think. Don't you think, if I wore that on my t-shirt?
Veya said,
I think I would like a t-shirt that says that on it, because I know sometimes when I cry, I feel as if, yeah, like, a bit of me thinks I'm not supposed to, as if I'm just being a girly girl or something.
See? Exactly. This world has got everybody so messed up. I mean, crying is so good for you, right, Heidi?
Heidi said, it's really good for you. In fact, when you feel like a cry, or when you're feeling like you're just really irritated or really angry or just yeah, like build up of all this bubbling inside you, like, and you just don't know what to do with it. If you can't go exercise or something like that, sometimes it's a good idea to just put on a movie that you know is going to make you cry. You know, like a sad movie? A sad movie. Everyone like cries on sad movies, don't they? I always, always cry at that one. What's that one where that man is in love with that woman and then he goes and dies really quick. She's left all alone, but he leaves her all those letters. What is it? Freya said, oh, me really likes that one. That one's called P.S. I Love You. That's it, said Heidi. Oh, that movie. Maybe tonight we should sit with some popcorn and get a nice glass of lemonade and sit in front of the telly with our cuddly blankets and all have a good cry watching P.S. I Love You. Because then you have a reason for crying because you're watching a sad movie, but at the same time, you're releasing all the cries that you need to release. You're peeing from your eyes and getting rid of all that built-up energy and like built up toxins and built up emotions that's inside your body that just need to go pow, but in the form of tears. That's so smart, said Cherry. So smart. I said we go do that right now, Heidi said. Maybe we should finish dinner first. Let's get dinner out the way and then we'll go watch a movie and have a good cry together. The cats finished cooking the spaghetti bolognese. And then later that evening, they got comfy on the couch with the popcorn and the lemonade and the snuggly, soft, warm blankets. They turned on their movie. And all three of them had a really good cry. They had a box of tissues next to them. Cherry was sat with a roll of toilet paper. And they cried and cried and released and then smiled and then cried and then cooed and smiled at the nice bits and then cried again. And then when it was over, they all gave each other a big hug, snuggled down on their cat bed, and fell fast asleep, ready for a whole new day when they woke up in the morning. The end.